Ian, what's your view on what seemed like another successful day for England out there?
Yeah, a really good day. I think at the start of the day we want to do, if we were batting the whole of the day, I thought it would be generally a good day for England. Our bowlers were outstanding yesterday. I think when you lose the toss and you want to, if you bowl Pakistan out in a day, I think that's an incredible effort. So to back that up today with the bat is really good. But again, we're only not even level yet. So we've got a lot of batting to do tomorrow. So if we can win the first session tomorrow up to lunch, then hopefully we can extend that lead and go as far as we can.
What was the wicket like to bat on out there?
I think probably a little bit better today. I think the wicket yesterday was a little bit tacky, which allowed it to spin a lot more. I think it spun a lot more than yesterday. I think as the day went on, we saw a bit more spin, but certainly when I started this morning, it really felt like it was just skidding on. In a way, hindsight, probably a good toss to lose. But obviously, again, the important thing, I suppose, in this part of the world is you want to score as many as you can first innings. And, we want one of these guys that are in now to try and get a big 100 as Cookie did in Abu Dhabi. If we do that, we'll put ourselves in a great place.
Nobody wants to get out on 40. Were you satisfied with getting 40 and sort of the way you made those runs?
Not really. I think, I was obviously happy to play a part and recognise that today and the tour, you're not going to come out and score at five and over. You're going to have to grind it out. It's going to have to look ugly at times. So I was really pleased to manage to do that. But again, I've had three starts, 60, 40 odd and another 40 today. And, I've set standard over a long time that I want to go on and get, big scores. And, it's disappointing. I'm sitting there pretty upset that, I couldn't have gone on. So, happy in a way that batting for 4 hours and getting us into a position, but it'd be nice to be there in the morning.
Tell me a bit about James Taylor and how he batted and how you think he developed from 2012 when you last saw him in an England shirt.
Really delighted for him. I think it shows as well. You can come in and you go back to county cricket, work really hard in your game and come back. And I think we've seen in the one-day side, but also now in the test matches that, he's taken his opportunity really well. And these are conditions that he's he's very good at. I've been on a few Lions tours to this part of the world with Titch as well, and watched him. He's a good sweeper of the ball. He's got quick feet. He's a busy player. So it's he played a fantastic knot today. I think as well as you can play in these conditions. So, and also that partnership with Johnny Bairstow at the end was brilliant, and I'm really pleased for Johnny the way he played as well.
Does he have the mentality, James Taylor, to go on and kick on tomorrow for a big score?
Certainly hope so. I mean, he seems to be that in county cricket. If he gets in, he'll go on and get a big one. So hopefully he can do that tomorrow for us. We've still got Samet and Dylan, the two bowlers as well, to come in, and every run we can go past Pakistan, I think, is a good thing.
What's the target for tomorrow and how big a lead do you think you need?
Oh, as many as we possibly can get, but hopefully this partnership can extend. If we can win the first hour tomorrow, keep Pakistan out there as long as we can. Also, it lets our bowlers get some good time off the field, so they'll be ready to charge in and hopefully get 10 more wickets.